Hello and welcome to the Scriptcase Fundamental Training. During this class, you are going to see how to create a project from scratch within the Scriptcase development environment. I'm currently starting at the Scriptcase environment login screen. Here, I will need to provide a username and password, which by default is admin and admin. Below that, I can select to keep me logged in, which is something I would advise for those lengthy projects. To the right of that, you can reset your password if email is set up for the environment. Below that, you can log in, or you can select the language for the development interface you want to use. The available languages for the environment include English, Spanish, French, German, Italian, Japanese, Russian, simplified Chinese, as well as traditional Chinese. Okay, so I will now log into the Scriptcase development environment and teach you more about the general options that are available for you to use. I will go through a basic introduction to the available menus and give you a brief description of what each tool is capable of and what it is typically used for. As you continue on in this training, you will learn much more about each tool during individual lessons. So now that I am logged in, I have the main menu and some buttons available, starting with Project, where you can manage general project options. Database, which includes different tools for you to manage your database projects and connections. Applications, with general options for the project, such as project import and export. Tools, with additional tools that Scriptcase offers that complement the development environment. Layout, where you can customize the theme, buttons, menu, icons, and so forth. Locals, where you can set up the local configuration for the applications. Modules is where you can create a logging system, as well as the security environment for login, logout, and registration, and so forth. We will then also have options, where we can change various settings regarding Scriptcase. And then finally, we have help, where we can access Scriptcase support, check our version, as well as update the license and so forth. To the top right of the interface, you can view your profile, where you can also have a portion of your Scriptcase license information. A quick link to my Scriptcase, which is a shortcut for the same link within the options. You will also find an option to log out of the Scriptcase environment below. The notification bell next to that is available to alert you when webinars or promotions are happening on our website. When available, you can click the available link and it will take you directly to the offer available. To the right of that, you can increase the size of your development environment by hiding the main menus. Within the superior menu and the project menu option, you are able to create a new project, open a project, close a project, execute a project, view the project properties, the default values of the project, your project version history, as well as its versioning. You can also export your project, import it, generate your source code, deploy your applications, create reports, show a diagram of your application connections, and also perform a project search. From the database menu option, you can create a new connection, edit an existing connection, import a database access, CSV or Excel from your SGDB. There is also a tool called SQL Builder, which assists in the creation of SQL queries. This includes a simple and intuitive wizard. There is also another tool called ER Diagram, which creates a diagram according to the database connection you are using. The diagram presents the relationships between the tables of the configured connection. From the application menu option, you can create new applications, generate batch applications, restore applications, save applications, generate the application source, execute them, export, as well as import applications. You can view the source code and also the session data. From the tools menu option, you can access the project's APIs. Shortcuts, templates, quick codes, the data dictionary, an express application editor, and you can also create your own help case system. View and add external as well as internal libraries, manage a task list, and also it includes a messaging system and converters for older project versions. From the layout menu option, you can access the project CSS styling, the CSS of the buttons, HTML templates, CSS for the menus, icons of the menu, the image manager, graph as well as chart themes, and also HTML templates. From the menu option locals, you can access the application translation tool and also the regional settings for the project. From the modules menu option, you can use the integrated security module and create multiple application logs. In the settings menu option is where you can change the administration options, access my Scriptcase again, change your password, modify your toolbar, and also your shortcut keys. From the final menu options where you can access the Scriptcase documentation directly on the Scriptcase website, as well as our technical support, where you can seek help if needed. Within the help option, you can also view the Scriptcase installation diagnosis, which provides a file containing all the configurations of the installation server and the status of installed extensions within the PHP setup. In check version, you can check if the Scriptcase installation is in its most current version, while in upgrade version, you can upgrade to the most recent version available. In license registration, you can register the Scriptcase environment using the login and password that you use on the website and also the serial number that was provided to you. You may notice are some options that are disabled within the menu as we have gone through them. These options are disabled because I am not using a project yet. Once a project has been created, you will then be able to access all of these. I should also note that our toolbar has some very specific functions. This toolbar is totally customizable, allowing you to adapt the toolbar to your personal preferences. Now let's explore the project navigation interface. Here, there is a search bar. This is a very useful search bar for filtering specific projects created within the Scriptcase environment. It is possible to switch between list as well as gallery views. You will also see how to create a project in a moment. But first, what is a project and what does it consist of within the Scriptcase environment? A project can be a single or a group of applications, themes and libraries that make sense to be together. It is a grouping of things with the same context, essentially a system. And in Scriptcase, creating a project is the initial step for any system which we want to implement. So let's go ahead and start to create a project. I will click the Create Project button and will then be presented with the new project interface. Within this screen, I have now available all of the pre-made or demo system templates. Each can serve as the basis in the creation of a specific project. You can also use them to learn from or to copy and import into your own projects. In this case, I will leave these project templates aside and create my own blank project. So I now have the project creation process and the breadcrumb steps available. I now need to follow this process, start, languages, themes, databases, and end, during which make the selections and provide some basic data. You can display an icon for the project by selecting one within the image management tool. There are plenty of icons and images available for use. There is also an option to upload your own files. You can do so within your own project, within the project selection, or within the public folder. The choice is yours. If you select general images, you can store them here, or within button images, or within icons, providing some organization. Once you've uploaded your files, you will then be able to select one and then use it within your project. For the project name, you can only use alphanumeric characters with a maximum of 32 characters. It is important to note that you can also start the name of a project with a number. The description of the project is where you can give a short description of what the project is about. In case you need something more extensive and detailed, you can use this field for additional project information. Continuing on to the next part, I will now have the language settings available. By default, Scriptcase functions as a multi-language system builder. you can from the ground up make your language selections and additions, configure your custom regional settings, and set the preferred character set. Using the multi-language features for a single language project can also help and provide some advantages in the management of your project texts. You can select which languages you want to include and which will be the default language by selecting the default option. Continuing on, next up is the theme selection. Scriptcase includes a collection of CSS configuration themes for all of the applications. This also includes sets of buttons which are used throughout the project. Although there is a possibility of using more than one theme, for example, multiple or even different themes for your created applications. For this example, I will only use the sweet blue theme and I will then also set it as my default. In the next part of the process, I will need to select how I will feed my applications with data. For this example, I will select MySQL. Here I can provide the name of the connection that I will create, for example, fundamentals. And now I will select the driver that I want to use for this project. I can then define the server hostname as well as the port, and then the username and password. And then I will select the database that I want to use by selecting the list database button. And then I can have a list of all of my databases. I'll select the samples. I am then able to test the connection before continuing. In the tab security, I have various options available allowing the use of SSL and to secure the connection further. If the SSL certificate is correct, it will be indicated here once it has been added. In the filter tab, I can define what will be visible in the connection. These options are very useful if you use a robust database with the use of schemas, or even a database with large amounts of tables where you are only interested in a small set of tables. In the advanced tab, I can select specific options such as the character set, the decimal separator, if it is a persistent connection, as well as an option for specific projects that use schema. This option significantly increases the performance in projects and essentially banks which use this type of connection. Now I will click on create and I am then ready to begin creating my applications within Scriptcase. Another important thing that I should show you before I finish this class is the possibility to change some of the settings that I have just now initially defined in the project creation process. I can make changes to the project I've just created by going to the project menu option and then to properties within the menu. Now do notice that all of a sudden all buttons are active. That is because the only way to access this window is to have an application started or created. And as you can see here, I do have the new application tab open next to the project properties tab. Now here within the project properties tab, I can edit the project description as well as the additional information I may have included at the beginning of the process. I can also change the icon I may have added, and within the locals tab, I can edit or add the languages which I may decide to include later on in the project development phase. I can also edit the default language and change the language set as default, or delete languages. Within the themes tab, it is possible to add, remove, or change the themes available for the project and its applications. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you again in the next class of this Scriptcase Fundamentals training.